Buenos días. Quisiera a todos bienvenidos al Seminario Internacional Assessment of Research and Teaching Outcomes at Higher Education Institutions. Profesor Mingers, Professor Glancer, Professor Harding, Professor Abrami, welcome to the Faculty of Psychology of the Universidad Complutense de Madrid. We want to let you know how much we appreciate your generosity of spending your time and sharing with us your expertise in the field of the assessment of research and teaching outcomes. Thank you very much. I should have a word of thanks to my dear colleague, Professor Javier Andres, who leads the Spanish Journal of Psychology and who took the initiative to organize this international seminar with the priceless assistance of Ana Montero. And I would like also to thank Professor Miguel Ángel García Pérez for his work in the coordination and Professor Fernando Chacón, the Dean of the Colegio Oficial de Psicólogos de Madrid, for his presence. How to be accurate in the evaluation of the research is a matter of great interest for all of us, especially in a context of pursuit of excellence, whatever excellence means, and certainly it couldn't be restricted to the issue of idiomatic indexes. Why I say so right here, right now? Because I want to point out that research is not just a personal effort, not even the effort of a research group. All we know that scientists have very different starting points and consequently different opportunities to conduct investigation, to reach outcomes, and finally publishing them to be evaluated. That's why institutional reforms and scientific change in research organization are needed, more needed in some places than others. Reputations and contribution of the researchers cannot, should not depend on themselves, but of having an optimal environment, an adequate local research capacity, diversity of funding agency programs, and stability, which supports, for instance, unusual research goals or approaches with uncertain outcomes and so on. Therefore, yes, we have to be very careful in assessing research outcomes, but we do not forget that to achieve them, we must demand that our institution provide us with the necessary conditions. The two most important functions of the university are the generation and transmission of knowledge. Both functions are equally important, both have the same level. But actually, these two functions do not have the same consideration. While always the value of research is underlined, many times the benefits of a good teaching tend to stay in the background. The American writer Henry Adams said, "The good teacher works for the eternity because no one can tell when his influence ends." Maybe it's poetic, maybe exaggerated, but what is certain is that we must know if we are teaching well, if we are fulfilling adequately one of our main duties as university professors. As much as teaching has some tangible character, we have to reach to assess it with the certainty that allows us to put it in value. Sorry if I change to Spanish, but to express emotion is better than mother language. Yo hubiera terminado esta intervención dándoles de nuevo la bienvenida, agradeciéndoles mi asistencia, cosa que hago, pero hoy realmente en ningún sitio público puede dejar de decirse, puede dejar de expresarse en voz alta el dolor, la compasión y la solidaridad por las víctimas de los atentados terroristas de París. Y en ningún sitio, y menos en una universidad, debe dejar de decirse que no hay idea, por legítima que sea, que pueda defenderse a través del terror y de la violencia. Por eso, sabiendo que todos ustedes albergan los mismos sentimientos, y con ellos por delante, nos vamos a dedicar a trabajar, que es a lo que hemos venido. No les voy a restar ni un minuto más del precioso que tenemos para abordar las claves de la evaluación de la docencia y de la investigación. Así que, una vez más, les agradezco su asistencia y espero que disfruten de unas jornadas que estoy segura de que van a ser muy interesantes. Muchas gracias.